Welcome back to the channel, everybody. As you can tell by the title and the thumbnail, today's going to be another gaming video. So Rainbow Six Siege, or Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege, just released a reveal, I guess, live stream covering the new operation that's going to be coming out soon. I forget what it's called. But we're going to be reacting to that today, and then at the end we're going to be just kind of discussing it. And yeah, that's it. So let's get started. Blood, drug reference.
Wait. Operation Neon Dawn is lighting up Rainbow Six Siege in a whole new way as a defender named Aruni is setting up laser gates. Angry laser gates. Look, I know they seem cool and kinda synth-wavy, but attackers, please don't touch them. I promise you it's for your own good. These gates have it out for drones, utility projectiles, and anyone on the attacking team, making Aruni a powerful architect of defense. Neon Dawn is also bringing a skyscraper map rework, as well as some key gameplay updates, including a nice little upgrade to Hibana's ex-Kairos launcher. Follow this channel and keep watching for more on the new season that's really going to punch above its weight. Aruni is a medium speed, medium armor defender from Thailand
in the game.
Who can slow down, stymie, and seriously singe attackers with her Surya gates. She can drape them over a soft or reinforced wall, set them up on windows, or use them to protect hatches, and they will completely cover the area. When she deploys them over doors, however, they leave a gap at the bottom for drones or nicely aimed projectiles.
Attackers
need to
take
advantage
of
that gap because the laser grid of a Surya gate will destroy any drone or utility projectile that hits it. And if an attacker touches it, it'll take a substantial bite out of their health. See, when a Surya gate destroys something,
I feel like now people are just
going to
throw it underneath the doors.
It deactivates temporarily to recharge. So, once an attacker uses some utility, like a grenade or a gadget, or burns some of their health to take down a Surya gate, that doorway is just a doorway again. Keep in mind that there is a short delay from zapping something to deactivation. This short delay is all Aruni needs to get her speedy P10 Roni submachine gun or her big bad MK14 EBR marksman rifle trained on the door in question. The first DMR to be wielded by a defender is not to be taken lightly.
Oh, and so
and
like, it deactivates
always has
for
her PRB92 sidearm standing by for close encounters. Influencing where encounters happen is one of Aruni's biggest strengths, as her Surya gates help the defending team reconfigure the map to their advantage. You see, while attackers get hung up dealing with laser problems, defenders can waltz right through. The Surya gate turns off when a defender is close, making them perfect for protecting your rotation holes. Just be careful not to set up an ambush too close to one while an attacker is nearby.
I didn't even think about that.
Or you may give your position away by turning off the
gate.
That'll
be sweet.
Even if the attackers do shut down a gate, Surya gate generators are indestructible. But while the gate will recharge, it won't reactivate automatically. Defenders will have to wait until the sparking effect stops and the generator flips open again. Then they'll have to shoot it to get the grid back online. And if Aruni ever decides to shift her defensive focus, the generators can be picked up and repositioned at will.
Of course.
The power of the Surya gates to disrupt attackers' plans and movements, plus the added barbed wire or proximity alarms in her secondary gadget slot, make Aruni a formidable asset to any defending team.
Good.
Oh,
okay.
And one more thing. You've seen that Aruni's prosthetics give her melee attack a little extra flair, but on the test server, she'll have some extra destructive power as well.
Oh my gosh!
PC players can download the test server for free and take Aruni's wall-busting left hook for a spin.
Oh, wow.
Just be sure to send the dev team some feedback and let them know what you think. Operation Neon Dawn is also bringing a new map rework for Skyscraper, in which they lowered the balcony count in order to lower the body count of defenders being shot from attackers kicking it outside the building. And there's also been some interior work on new connectors and bomb site tweaks.
Weird.
A few gameplay updates are inbound as well, notably the Hibana update I mentioned earlier.
That's interesting.
She can now toggle her gadget.
So you can change the
four or six
the X and Y array.
You'll also notice that Echo's yokai drones are now always visible, so you'll know where your splitting headaches are coming from. And Jaeger's ADS gadget now operates a bit differently. The ADS will now take out one projectile and then need to recharge before zapping another. Also, for defenders who like a good run out now and then, please note that the reveal timer has been shortened and step lively. Some improvements to diffuser planting and gadget placement interactions round out the list of gameplay updates that will be free for all players when Operation Neon Dawn launches. The skyscraper map rework will also be free, and a Rooney will be available at launch for all Year 5 pass holders.
That's me.
Everyone else can unlock her 7 days later for Renown or R6 credits. Follow this channel to stay up on the latest in Siege, and visit us at news.ubisoft.com.
Okay. That was interesting. Overall, just looks like another operation to me. I think the Defender looks really good. She's pretty unique. I think she'll be super helpful for rotation holes and I don't know. We'll see, I guess. I'll probably make a video on it with me and my friends. So stay tuned for more content, as always. And I think that's it. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and take care. See you in the next one.